Dan Patrick.
This is as good as it's going to get. I love that. Tony Stewart joining us here in the Man Cave. How difficult were you to deal with when you were in the car?
It depends on which crew chief you ask, but I think Greg Zipadelli probably was the one that said I was probably the most difficult to handle. Him and I were together at Joe Gibbs Racing for 10 years.
But it's kind of hard to drive at 200 miles an hour and you're yelling at somebody.
Oh, no, it's easy. It's a lot easier than you think it is.
Well, I can yell at the kids in the back seat when I'm going 45. You're going a little bit faster now.
All you got to do is just push a button on the steering wheel and you can yell at anybody you want that has a radio on your frequencies.
I got Kurt Warner in the Hall of Fame. That was another project I worked on. When you see Brady, did you ever talk about that Super Bowl?
We haven't talked about it a lot, you know, maybe just in general terms and kind of that moment. And, you know, just kind of funny when you look back on it now that it was kind of my end of the times in St. Louis and the greatest show on turf and the beginning of what he would end up becoming.
You could have changed history. If you beat Brady, who knows?
Exactly. You know, I mean, you look at it from a lot of different perspectives. I may never have gone to Arizona.
And we say good morning to Rich Eisen, and fresh off an interview with Jerry Seinfeld recently. How'd that go?
My favorite part is when I asked him about the intentional walk, the new intentional walk. And he doesn't like the fact that you just let the guy to go to first base. And he equated that to people who just text him the letter K.
Fritzy will send me a detailed text, very detailed.
Mm-hmm.
And then I crush him by just sending back the letter K.
I hate that.
He's Joe Thomas, the Browns offensive tackle, future Hall of Famer. Somehow squeezed in 10,000 consecutive snaps, and we didn't even know it. Did you get anything? A cake? A plaque? What do you get?
I was kind of waiting for you to send me something.
What would you like, Joe, that I could send that really would commemorate an incredible, incredible moment in your life?
The number one thing would be maybe a cake with your face on it, just saying congratulations and giving me the double gun.
Double bird or double gun?
Either one, whatever you prefer.
Next to the show with Dan Patrick.
This is as good as it's going to get. I love that.
The Dan Patrick Show, weekday mornings on Audience.